Hey, a pleasant good day, everybody. This is Sports Fan News. I'm Joe Boric. A pleasant special thanks to you, those of you that have subscribed this far. Please continue to show the love and support. I really love you and appreciate you for it down below on the sub button. But this is going to be the next edition of the Ghostly Take as we talk about some recent Phantoms transactions, as well as, of course, a quick coverage of the postponement. For those that don't know yet, the postponement of the game against the Hartford Wolfpack on Friday due to the fact that the COVID protocols are still involving the Hartford Wolfpack. But the Phantoms have received some good news when it comes to guys coming back. Defenseman Mason Millman has been reassigned by the Flyers to Reading, which is more on a conditioning stint. Obviously, the youngster played very well in the AHL last year. And as many pointed out, like Bob Rotruck in his post-game articles, as he writes so well, and also on the broadcast, he looked like he was never overwhelmed out there as a youngster, so I feel like that's just a conditioning stint going down to Reading, but we're definitely welcoming down covering the ECHL Reading. Having that type of skilled player on defense down there would be great to see for a couple games. And then also Ryan McKinnon, who's only played in 4 games with the Phantoms and hasn't played in any with Reading, has been sent back down to the Reading Royals as well. And then John Gillies, because he signed a two-way deal, claps up for him. He did sign a two-way deal with the St. Louis Blues coming off of a PTO, so now he has another chance to get back in the NHL, and he decided to move on, so I don't blame him for that. It's unfortunate because I liked what I saw in the first game against Bridgeport, and we can have as much goaltending with Ersan injured depth as we want, and you need to have as much goaltending depth, obviously. So it was an unfortunate thing, but it is what it is. Now Patty Nagel gets another chance to come up, who has played exceptional, obviously, and just has a 3-2 loss to the Marlies because Josh Hosang deked his way through our entire defense. His 198 career wins for Nagel is the ECHL's most of an active player and his 5th all-time. So he's been a hell of a goaltender, one of the best all-time down there, and has looked good in some short AHL stints, excuse me if I could speak the English language, of late. But I think it's a good idea to give Millman a conditioning stint in the ECHL, and it's a very good idea to let Patty Nagel get rewarded. And I wish John Gillies all the best in the St. Louis Blues organization. Another move that was made was Michaud, who did not play in any games, of course. He was let go from his PTO, where, of course, Nick Master, my fellow high school alum, did play in a game for the Phantoms, got let go from his PTO. That's the devils of a PTO. You don't know if you're ever going to stick around, but is kicking butt for the Maine Mariners, who, of course, run by former Flyer Daniel Briere. So in this Ghostly Take, we're going to cap it off after we talked about the recent transactions where Pat Nagel gets rewarded for his great play again, and because of John Gillies going off, gets another opportunity in the AHL, and I think just like he looked at the Marlies game, he will look good again. Millman, again, is on a conditioning stint, I would call it more so, in Reading, but it'll be great to have a talent of his level down there with Reading to see. And then Michaud got released from his PTO. Nick Lappin, who is the player of the week last week, I assume we're going to keep around, and I hope we keep around having the 60 career NHL games and mixing in nicely. You need the veteran presence, especially with the hits to the forward core, because as we wrap up this video, the final thing is claps up to Jackson's Cage. Yes, it's a hit to the Phantoms forward core, but I'm always going to be happy being someone that covers all 3 teams for Nitty Gritty, for anybody that gets to live their dream and gets called up. Cates has 4 games in the NHL, looked solid in his cup of coffee last year. Obviously, is a quicker skater. It seems like with Mike Yeo, this team wants to add more speed plus pace to the play that we saw more in Sunday's game in the NHL. Obviously, you saw a dead offense if you watched the game yesterday against the Devils. So they want to bring in more energy. Frost was the most energized guy, who's a guy that's playing to stay in the lineup. You want to bring in more guys at this point when you're trying to get a win that are playing to stay in the lineup. Like Cates, who has the great passing prowess, was on a 3-game assist streak recently, to kind of get the guys going and try to thrive off of that energy since those guys are playing to keep their behinds in that lineup. But this has been the latest edition of the Ghostly Take as we recap the postponement of the game against the Hartford Wolfpack, and then Jackson Cage call up, Mason Willman getting a conditioning stint with Reading, Ryan McKinnon getting sent back to Reading, maybe you're finally getting to a game down there, and then Pat Nagel getting moved back up, so Hayden Hawkey now will become One of the two key goaltenders with Redding, again, combined with Kirill Ustamenko, of course, that's been down there. Usti, of course, is going to get another big opportunity again here to restabilize himself coming off of an injury. So everybody have a great, safe, and pleasant day. This has been the latest edition of the Ghostly Take by Sports Fan News. If you enjoy the content, please continue to show your love and support by subscribing down below. Peace out, everybody, and enjoy the rest of the season.